just got done installing adjustable shocks in your car. You're going to take it out for the first drive. Where do I set the valving? Let's find out. All right, so you got your car all set up with adjustable shocks. You're going to take it out for the first drive. And often times we get a call asking, how do I set the valving for the first time out? In the instructions, you'll find some good recommendations if you're street driving, if you're drag racing, if you're more of a pro touring person that wants more handling. But you know what? Me, I like taking the car out and playing around with the dials. I mean, that's what they're there for. And so oftentimes what I do is I start with the shocks at full zero, full counterclockwise. There's 18 clicks for each knob that you have, whether you have double adjustables or singles, but set the shocks at zero and go out for a spin. Go test them out, see how they feel. Now, when you go out to take a drive, I normally don't go driving a 10-mile loop coming back. I find a stretch of road that has a good couple miles of, you know, some straight line areas, some curves for handling, some bumps for some imperfections in the road. And I use that as my test road, right? And if you were to take the car and drive that 2-mile stretch, and you have a nice safe spot to pull off, you can turn the shocks up right there in this, you know, in a parking lot or a safe spot that you stop at. Just reach underneath, turn them up maybe 4 or 6 clicks at a time, both for the front and the rear. And drive that same stretch of road that you just got done driving back to that starting point. And that'll give you a quick back-to-back comparison of the adjustments that you had. Now, as you keep going firmer in the valving, I oftentimes recommend adjust it until it gets too stiff, right? It's kind of like the you never know how good it could be until you go too far type of thing. And if you were to adjust it to where it gets too stiff, now you start to understand the range. And so you can back your valving off from there. Now, one of the things I like to do is, you know, once you start dialing in, you know, and starting to really find that happy medium where it feels really good to you, is be conscious of what the front and the rear of the car are doing. Kind of an old adage I like to go by is, if you feel it in your feet, it's coming from the front of the car. If you feel it in your seat, it's coming from the back of the car. So be conscious of that. What are you feeling? And, you know, also be conscious to the different types of suspension that's on your car. If you have a solid axle versus independent front suspension, the shocks are gonna respond a little bit differently. And with that, I oftentimes run the rear shocks a little bit softer, and you'll see that reflected in your instructions. The rear shocks are oftentimes set softer than the fronts are. But again, have fun with it. Go out and drive the car. Figure out what works best for you. There is no wrong answer to how you adjust your shocks, but hopefully starting at the softest setting and working yourself stiffer will be a good way for you to dial in your suspension on that first try out. So for more information on this, make sure to check out our website, QA1.net. We have a whole text section of different tips and tricks for you. And most importantly, go drive it. Sorry, this part takes a little while. All right, so you just got done installing. Yeah, that was weird.